The rain just kept falling. Thaddeus Spyder listened to the giant drops hitting the roof over and over again as he did his math homework for the fourth time. It was perfect the first time, but he was bored and there was nothing else to do. Thaddeus had read all the books in the house twice, and now he was redoing his homework over and over again, and still it kept raining. Gracey, Thaddeus's older sister, was busy making sculptures out of webs. Thaddeus watched Gracey build a massive mobile of the solar system. She had been weaving elaborate horses and monsters and other things out of spider webs for days. The spider family were orb weaver spiders, so weaving things out of webs was something they could all do, but Gracey was special. She was an artist, or so she kept reminding Thaddeus and their older brother Curt. Thaddeus could spin a decent web, but he had to work really hard at it, while Curt did only what he needed to pass a test. Gracey, however, was at the top of the advanced web-spinning class at school and made sure Thaddeus and Curt never forgot it. Right now, she was really bored, too. Web-spinning involved a lot of math and building skills. You had to know how to use the right combination of sticky webs and strong webs. It was required learning for all spiders because it was a survival skill and, well, they were spiders. Making webs is what spiders do. When it came to survival, though, Curt was an expert. He wasn't really interested in books or art. All he cared about was adventure. He found it impossible to sit still, and his mind was constantly plotting races and stunts and things that involved danger. The webs he would spin were meant to help him rappel down from great heights or catapult into the neighbor's yard. While it rained outside, Curt created an obstacle course in the living room with jumps, swings, trampolines, and other things that daredevils loved. He raced through the course over and over to improve his time. Now he tore through his course again. Thaddeus had lost count of how many times he had done it. This time, he set a new course speed record. "Yes!" Curt cried, raising his front legs in triumph. 2 seconds off my best time!" Unfortunately for Curt, nobody else in the house was paying attention. He'd been running that course over and over for 3 days. Of the three spider children, Gracey was the tallest, as was often the case with orb weaver spiders. Girls were usually bigger than the boys. Like all of them, she was light reddish brown with white stripes wrapping around her legs. She had long brown hair that she liked to keep in long braids. Down her back was a long white stripe with delicate points reaching out from it. Curt also had reddish-brown legs, but he liked his hair swooping over his eyes because he thought it looked cool, and he had white dots on his back that were all in a straight line. Thaddeus was the smallest, and he liked things to be very precise. His hair was short, and on his back was a white diamond shape. All of them had tiny white bristles, resembling hair running up and down their legs. Curt's legs, in particular, were very bristly. The three spider children were so different. They argued a lot, like most brothers and sisters did, but they were still the best of friends. Today, though, after being inside for 3 whole days, they were just bored. Martha Spider, mother of Thaddeus, Gracey, and Curt, was ready for the rain to be over, too. She had used up all her rainy day activity suggestions on the first day of the downpour, and now they were on day 3. Spider children cooped up in a house for that many days can only mean one thing, a big mess. She firmly said no when they begged her to let them build a massive pirate ship in the living room. Thaddeus could tell his mother was impatient by the number of times she rolled her 8 eyes whenever they did something. No matter how many eyes they have, the mom eye roll is universally understood. Before the three spiders went to bed, they all pressed their glum faces against the living room window. The rain was falling in gigantic droplets, running down the window and making everything outside look dark and blurry. "Cheer up, you three. The forecast says it's supposed to be sunny tomorrow, and that will make all of us happy. Now, get ready for bed. Your dad is going to video call in a few minutes to say goodnight.